napkin serves for mostly two reasons. One is to take away the color from the brush instead of putting it immediately there, and the water gets muddy immediately. But also good serves to take away the color from the drawing when you don't want something you and it's still wet. Then we go into the color. So this one basically I don't need it anymore. And the watercolor set becomes in two types. One is cubes. And generally that's used when you make watercolors. But for our intention, it's better to use this kind of watercolor pens, which could be at least you need at least 12 colors. Otherwise, it would be difficult for you to find the color that you want to mix with, that you want to use. And that's about it in terms of tools. The last thing is the paper. In this case are blocks which are glued together so that even if you pour water, the paper doesn't wrinkle too much. It's already flat and stays flat. When you finish the drawing, you just put a knife here and take the paper. Otherwise, you may use a block which could be more nice to look at as a sketchbook. But at the same time, when you use block like this, you do a watercolor, then maybe you want to do another one, and you have to wait that everything is dry. While in this way, maybe you cut it off, you let it there, and you start another one. But also, because it doesn't have the glue around, it tends to be a little bit more wavy and wrinkled, so that if you get the paper that wrinkled, then the color goes in the pockets, and it doesn't have possibility of being homogeneous. Otherwise, many painters, more professional, they go around with a piece of plywood. They take the paper maybe from, you know, they buy the paper separately, so they cut it the way they want, they put it on the piece of plywood and with a tape around. They dries, it's ready to be painted again, and then you take away the tape, and the paper stays flat, but it's more complicated. You have to go around with a piece of plywood. In this case, it's easier. So, basically, you're ready to start, and now, generally, you go around to do sketches, you know, sketches of buildings. But it could be applied to many other occasions. It could be a diagram or just an elevation, big thing, and you put some color on. In this case, I think since we are here, since it's a nice view, I may try to do a standard view, a normal view. And maybe I use this as a sample view. I can decide if the drawing should be this way, or the drawing should be this way. Let's keep it this way. So when you do a drawing like this, you have to find a nice place, you know, when you are outside, you have to find a place that is comfortable. The shadows, unfortunately, today are not strong. There is not a direct sun, which would be better, because when there is a direct sun, you see shadows, cast shadows against the walls, and then you copy the shadow and the building come out in a better way. In this case, if the sun is not direct, you have to just use the proper shadows. So it means this side of the building will be a little darker than this side, but I don't know exactly cast shadows. So in terms of making sketches, you know, one of the first things you have to figure out is what is the frame of your drawing? Do you want us to show the tower and this portico and a little bit, or do you want to show more of it? So depending on that, you have to decide a little bit first, you know, you can make a little dimension like this, you see the proportion. So probably we'll have the portico here, the tower here, and these things here. But one of the most important things is to know where your eyes are. My eyes are at this height. And so the horizon line would be about this side here. I draw a straight line here. And I try to be straight, also helping myself with the edge of the board. It could even be lower. You know, it could even be a little lower in this case. And if I decide to do something, you know, quickly I do that. Then I have to figure out my viewpoint, which is right in front of me in this case, because this would be a very important element. It would be a little bit after on the horizon line, because all the line that goes in that direction, they are parallel, they will vanish here. Okay, then now I'm ready to start. Could we move a little bit so I see better? I'm ready to start, and you know, I imagine that this is bigger. I take a little bit of dimension, so you know, this is about, if this is the building, the tower would be about here. So maybe there is a first line which is here, another line which is here, another line which is here. So it's about half size, and here would be this other line. Okay, now I'm starting to use the vanishing point, which is this one. And I'm thinking, you know, this kind of lines. And here I start to draw the space in between so that this comes pretty well. You know, I may realize that this wasn't tilted enough. I also show you, you know, how you change your things, because the vanishing point is probably here, it's more close here. So it's tilted enough because I look at the shape of this space. And then here, slowly I am building the cubes, I'm building the major volume. Can you move? No, I see. This is the flat part. And here, you know, this is still my vanishing point. You know, I get to see this as an element. And these are the steps. Sketchy, you know, I'm not here it looks simple, but there is a lot of stuff going on in the back there, and I want to be sure that more of it is. So when I do the drawing, the coloring, I don't have to add while I'm drawing it too much. Okay, now I pass to draw the tower. Clearly, it should look like it's going into a vanishing point there, far away there. And here it's straight. And this needs to be used this. So this would be very narrow on this side. Very, very narrow. The vanishing point to give a sensation of the floor. Yes. And I can erase some of the construction lines. And at this point, I may start to think about the watercolor, but before, there are some elements that I would like to add because they are important for the understanding how the building is made, this kind of subdivision. And mostly this part, which needs some work, because this is where the steps are, but then there is I can finish this with the color immediately after that. So you see, I'm using the eraser also quite a bit, especially to take out. Okay, at this point,